In the 1830s, under concern for social justice, especially with convicts and Indigenous people, an outcome of his visit was the development of a movement of Quakers in Australia, of which we have reached a significant point in our time. And so we honour him in the lecture series. We're especially favoured this year because, as members of the Asia West Pacific section of the Friends World Committee for Consultation, Australia Yearly Meeting welcomes visitors from that region to our gatherings. And in this occasion, we not only have a visitor, but we also have separate visit from Chonyun Kim from Korea. Chonyun Kim is a Quaker from the Daejeon Quaker Meeting in South Korea. He's a professor of sociology. He edits a magazine on Hamsok Hom, the prominent Korean friend known internationally for his peace and justice witness. Chonyun Kim is deeply committed to peace and care for the environment. His special interest is in the encounter between Quaker mysticism and Taoism. He attended the World Gathering of Friends in Peru in January 2016, followed shortly after by attending our yearly meeting in July 2016. He is an Alternatives to Violence program Korea facilitator. He will also give a public lecture later this year at the German Quaker Yearly Meeting. So he is someone of many skills and talents. His theme tonight is an encounter between Quaker mysticism and Taoism in everyday life. The presentation he will use tonight, and what you will see on the screen, and what you will read in the book, is not a direct translation from his Korean, but an English version designed to make it easier for English readers to follow. Copies of the lecture will be available in a printed form afterwards for the special price of $10 tonight outside in the foyer, and supper will be served across the way in the foyer of the church. Now, the normal process for these lectures is that we have a period of silence and the speaker begins when he's ready. And when he's finished, he sits down again and we have a further period of silence before the shaking of hands to conclude the session. There's no opportunity for questions and comments tonight. Those of you who will be here tomorrow will have a chance to do that at 4 o'clock when we have a feedback session with him.
Dear friend, thank you very much for invite to the council lecture. Today evening, evening, I will speak about an encounter between clinical mysticism and Taoism in everyday life. My English pronunciation and accent is very bad. Therefore, you need more understanding power, I hope. It is symbol image of my lecture. About this, I will tomorrow explain. Everything is changing, including religion. There is tradition and identity, and also new enlightenment. Some religious contents may disappear, and a new abundant meaning may develop. I have to discover for myself what it is to be Quaker. This is very difficult. Concepts such as inner light, inner voice are difficult. They are closely related to everyday life. I became more curious about Quaker's attitude to real life than any literal understanding of this concept. Quakers are trying to accomplish a peace, simplicity, equality, community, truth, sustainability, and integrity. These are adaptable to the situation. How do we keep the tradition of living a simple life in a modern civilization that advocates a complex life with many superfluities? Taoism values the peaceful, simple, general, and ordinary things, a life based on nature. Taoism can supplement and expand Quakerism. Spirituality and mysticism are in the events we meet in everyday life. This is Chinese Tao. In this lecture, I look at, firstly, the general religious life in the Korean society I grew up in. Secondly, Confucianism, Buddhism, the folk religions, Christianity. And thirdly, the key points of Quakerism and Taoism. Fourthly, the life and thought of Hamsa Kwon, the early Korean Quaker, advocate of peace and justice. And finally, my own life as a Quaker. What I write is not my claims, but questions and expressions of wonder. Quakerism, a religion for a new era. It can become this by combining the essence of one's own cultural and religious traditions with clericalism. Only clerics follow the faith and truth, even though they were treated harshly. They practice their faith in everyday life. This is difficult for me to do. I am living in a mainstream atmosphere of religion without religion. I have a desire to share my concern. How can we live a life that realizes truth in a secular society and culture? My upbringing and the religiosity around me. I was raised in the non-religious tradition of a Confucian family. We had a house for the dead ancestors in our house. Ancestor worship was strong. This everyday religion was not organized. Confucianism is an ethics based on human goodness, etiquette, and wisdom. It is about living harmoniously with the conflicts in life. My village, at year end or new year, we made sacrifices for the peace of the village. And the guardian deity was built at the entrance to the village. People prayed to their gods according to their own family tradition. The people worshipped at large rocks, trees, valleys, and old wells. In this way, God was present in people's daily lives. I grew up in a living culture where various religions melded through stories and ordinary life, not as systematic education or religious activities. Christianity, a Protestant. When I was in my teens, I attended church. I experienced hymns, prayers, the Bible, sermon. I could not understand what it meant that Jesus died for me, to believe in him, militant hymns, original sin. There is no such concept in Korean religions, heaven and hell. I encountered Quakerism through Hans Kern and Soul Meeting. Hans' translation of Howard Brinton, Quakers for 300 years. I and my wife lived in Germany and we worshipped with German Quakers. She's my wife and I. we intended to return to Daejeon, and we wanted to start a meeting there when we returned. So we applied for and became members through German papers. It is worship form in Korea. It is joint meeting Seoul and last year. Daejeon meeting. We meet every Sunday for 1 hour of unprogrammed worship, 1 hour study, and then a shared meal. After 6 years, we registered with Friends World Committee for Consultation, the umbrella organization for Quakers. We study the Bible, Quaker literature, the Buddhist scriptures, Taoist scriptures, Confucian classics. Korea practices religious pluralism. Buddhism and Confucianism have been national ruling ideals at different times. Taoism and folk religion have led people's everyday life. Christianity and Catholicism. Catholicism came in the later half of the 18th century. The Church taught that all humans are equal before God. The ruling class oppressed Catholics. Protestantism came a century later. Missionaries wrote medicine, science, education, technology, democratic ideas. Korea was under Japanese rule from 1910 to 1945. And Protestant Christianity helped Koreans oppose Japanese rule. In a multi-religious society like Korea, one's own religion is worked out with other religions. All religions start in their own way and place, and travel in parallel, but over time they converge. They begin with opposition, but over time they come close. There is in Korea an atmosphere of mutual toleration. For example, my great-grandmother lost some family members, so she became a Christian. However, she prayed in the traditional Korean way. We believe that refreshing the body at dawn enhances our prayers. She got up early in the morning, filled a pottery bowl with clean water, and washed her face, put her hands together, rubbing them and praying to God. Traditional religions and Christianity. the reaching of new religion must be related to what is already there. Religions evolve in relation to each other. Is the ultimate reality personal? The Christians conceive of God as having a personality. Confucianist, Buddhist, and Taoist do not conceive of God as having a personality. But there is an ultimate reality that functions like God. All religions are concerned with the ultimate, God, heaven, the Tao, the Absolute, etc. Religion is about being at one with oneself through direct, different experience of contact with the ultimate being. Many religions are concerned with escaping from sin or going beyond pain into the world of liberation. Confucianism does not pray for liberation from sin, but for the well-being of the nation and the human race, and for solving temporal problems. A constant self-discipline is needed to follow the will of heaven. Korea does not provide religious education of systematic organization. Confucianism is a life ethic regulating human and social relations. Koreans see it as natural to pursue self-growth and reflection. Shamanistic folk religion continues to be created. Is deeply rooted in the daily life and emotions of Koreans. Buddhism has many temples and schools training monks, has universities and high schools comfort the dying. Mahayana Buddhism teaches that there is an absolute in the relative. One can find nirvana in many things, like the forest. There is sacredness in the mundane world. This Buddhist tradition has united with the four religions and continues ancestor worship. The Buddhist concepts of nirvana and liberation helped in the non-confrontational acceptance of Christian concepts of salvation and heaven. Taoism in Korea has no shrines, teachers, or organization. It teaches a life of simplicity and honesty in harmony with nature and contemplative practice. the power of the ultimate reality can be experienced through emptiness, but cannot be adequately expressed in words. Tao Te King, Chapter 1, the Tao that can be spoken of is not the eternal Tao. The name that can be named is not the eternal name. The unnameable is the beginning of heaven and earth. The unnameable is the mother of all. Therefore, the deed of your desire. It cannot be adequately expressed in infinite human thought, studies, language, and feelings. Everything that comes out of the ultimate is infinitely mysterious and delicate. There is no shape, no image. Therefore, it cannot be recognized objectively through the rational thought. It is only talked about as a symbol, and because the name and reality do not coincide at the moment of naming. In the end, it is reality that needs to be recognized, experienced, and felt through denial. In particular, the silent prayer in Quaker worship could reference the Chan meditation of Buddhism. The purpose of Chan meditation is to realize the ultimate truth by first emptying the mind. One must abandon all obsessions. In this way, one realizes the truth of nothingness as the ultimate reality beyond all relative things. One can reach the level of liberation which meets the Buddha through the intuition of the inner mind. This is like the prayers of Christian contemplatives who empty their minds and open themselves to God alone. And it is consistent with the worship of Quaker, who in the midst of calmness seeks and waits for the promptings of God. In other words, and could encounter through self-denial. Chan Buddhist meditation is like Taoism. The ultimate truth is achieved by emptying the mind. It's consistent with Quaker worship. The Quaker practice of emptying the mind to seek the promptings of God. Reading the Tao Te King, there is no fixed point that a person must reach, but each needs to understand the progress of the best of their ability. The mystic experience of Taoism in dark, neutral, uncertain. It is not based on dogma but on the direct experience of God. It naturally that you or I, or a Christian or a pagan, or forgetter. I am not the only son, so now you have to sacrifice your self-creed. Its truth is all past mankind and is the future humanity. In this way, no one will perish. Hamsokon says that a new religion is needed. An old religion predicts and orders a new one. In the same way, a severe shock results in a new flow. Besides that, a new religion is being born. The nature of modern war is very different from before. Progress in atomic science, changes in people's worldviews, the development of biotechnology. The whole world is a single network. The new religion will be more rational, which belongs to the realm of science. Neither science nor religion wins. Those who are trapped in the emotions of winning and losing cannot go to heaven. It is not religion or science until one enters the world of eternal infinity. We need a new perspective to reunite body and soul. Jung-hee Lee leads a meditation session this photo. The new religion is of the here and now. Without thinking of the here and now, there can be no salvation and no repentance. Of course, the purpose is heaven. It is the way of religion to ascend to heaven. But there are no birds that fly without encountering land. Evil or sin is a social phenomenon. Leading religion is a systematic activity of those who are determined to fight against evil. Authentic religion makes people more alive. If God is the head, his feet are the people. God's service is the service of the people. The highest is the lowest. What you do to one of the least of my brothers and sisters is what you do to me. An extremely small organization is needed to wake up the people, the CR, the seed. A summary of Hamsokon's argument, he is freed from the idea that Christianity is the only true religion and that the Bible alone proclaims complete truth. All religions represent the word of God. The world must be one, encompassing science and globalization. Therefore, nationalism must be overcome. A religion of one's own asks a believer to come face to face with God without a mediator. God has given the belief of freedom. God has given the belief of freedom. Mm. The free individual represents the whole. God represents the whole as a flow in the personal life. To serve your God with all your heart and all your soul, and serve your neighbor as yourself. You are in me and I am in you. I am the whole within you. Ham's teachings count the individual and the whole are not separate to Ham. The seed Sian is both the individual and the whole. Therefore, Ham circumcises the spiritual community as a new religion that frees the individual while focusing on the individual as a whole. He experiences this impeccably. Ham was committed to opposing one. He saw that existing religions would not endure because they were closely connected with politics. He had a new vision of nationhood. A nation must be for the people, not the people for the nation. Different names and similar concepts. Human behavior is the same whether expressed as sin in Christianity or as ignorance in Hinduism and Buddhism. Salvation in Christianity is nirvana in Buddhism. In this way, there is nothing to cause conflict between the two religions. The place that Lao Tse and Chuang Tse call Tao is the place of God that Christians seek. And this is the Lao Tse, the Chinese Lao Tse. Ham Sokon did not wish to distinguish between the plural, the whole, the one, between the East and the West, between Christianity, Buddhism, Zen, and Taoism. We are all children of God. Religion is not complete. It continues to change, flows, and grow. Religion is living, it is process, but is unfinished and growing. Ham created this idea of the Sial. The Sial refers to the pure man. A good example of the pure man is Jesus. To Jesus, a child represents purity. No one can enter the kingdom of heaven unless he is like a child. The way to achieve this is to be born again, to return to one's original innocent self. Eastern thought is the same. Lao Tse taught that the person who becomes as a child has very deep virtue. The childlike mind is the true heart. Ham on Lao Tse and Chuang Tse. These great Taoist masters intended to live beyond the phenomenon of reality. Reality is not evil, it is natural and inevitable. We are thinking beings, so our attitudes are what matters. It is a simple picture for Lao Tzu. The relative emerges from the absolute by being the relative apart from the absolute, and that is transcending duality. The lives of Lao Tzu and Chuang Tzu begin with Tao and end at Tao. To achieve the way, the Tao, Lao Tzu emphasizes silence, unselfishness, doing nothing, weakness, non-violence. The Tao is causeless because it is the basis of everything. What can be done to achieve the way, Tao? Lao Tzu was a pacifist. At the time of the Chun Chu state, which emphasized national prosperity and military power, Lao Tzu emphasized doing nothing rather than becoming political. The king sent a messenger to Chuang Tzu to offer him a high post in the government. As poor as Chuang Tzu was, he said he preferred to be like pigs herded into the gutter, rather than living in a house designed for extravagant ceremony. He had a fiery face to rescue Sial, who lived under a tyrannical ruler. Han wrote The Spirit of Wilderness. This spirit is seen in the lives of prophets, such as Isaiah, Jeremiah, and Amos. And in the lives of Lao Tzu and Chuang Tzu, and in Jesus and the Kingdom of Heaven. Hans Kuhn's critic of nationalism is divided from the unregulated politics of Lao Tzu and Chuang Tzu, and from Jesus and the concept of Kingdom of God, of Heaven. Is this also the Quaker spirit? It is the fusion of these ideas that leads to a new world of truth and a nation that does not ignore or forsake the real world. My life as a Quaker. Am I able to practice Quakerism in my daily life? When I think about it, I have grave doubts. Can I keep the Quaker tradition of seeing faith and practice equally important as one? In today's highly civilized society, I have to live a luxury compared with ancient times. So what is humble and simple living? How can I live without destroying the nature's ecosystem when I am aware that Earth itself is environmental destruction? In what way can we live together peacefully when the pattern of life leads to competition and strife from beginning to end? In an overly systemized and organized society, is it possible to live on the soul guidance like a natural spirit? In a modern society becoming increasingly nationalistic and militaristic, how can I practice the philosophy that humankind belongs to one life system? When I think about it, my breath seems to be stifled, but I feel that finding a little road to life in the frustrating and obstructive reality is essential for a Quaker. I am seeking a practical narrow path that captures a feeling from an invisible reality, a mystical experience. Korea is divided into two. The entire human race must transcend nations and countries. In order to create a peaceful society, I must be peaceful, live with a peaceful mind, and share peace with the people around me. In practice, keeping a smile on my face and in my mind. I must endeavor to acknowledge and tolerate others, but I should also challenge the tradition and social trend of making everything uniform. Pilgrimage activities for peace. I am starting a peace pilgrimage to input the energy of peace into places of severe conflict. To remind us that we are all different and we are all one. The picture is of the beginning of a pilgrimage in March 2018, starting at the place where the independence movement against the Japanese began on 1st March 1990. My participation in ADP. We need to train individuals creatively to change their violent tendencies. It is mandala for ADP. Amnesty International is another way I am participating in making peace. To do so, I must experience other cultures, religions, people, civilizations, and customs, find their core values, always seeking truth with an open mind. Living this way is my life task. So spreading the message through research, lectures, forums with this small voice. Being a friend to troubled people. In daily life, assisting others to love their enemy they bless those that are different. Normal life is mystical. Taoism teaches that softness encompasses strength and dissolves rigidity. This can become habits in daily life. This training begins with the belief that all people have an inner light, that there is an inner teacher, and that all can find a way to learn it and get in touch with Tao. This is the mystical experience of everyday life. Mysticism is very normal life. However, in contemporary civilized society, Koreans especially lack sufficient daily rest and do not practice deep breathing. Modern society is an exhausted society. I do not have a happy ability and vision to lead to a place of peace those who feel tired, but I want to create an atmosphere where I can talk with them as a friend. I want to be a friend to troubled people who cannot establish themselves or who are conflicted. I feel that this is a way to live with the truth in my own heart, in my heart. Language, culture, customs, clothing, lifestyles, religion, race, are different. These differences, the difference offers hope. Like water, all truths come from one source and return to it. For example, the stream where I live flows from the nearby mountain. It provides my farmland and my house with water. I depend on the water. Water flows and flows into the vast ocean. The water becomes as one. In the end, the water that flows into rivers and eventually into the sea remain comfortable as friends do. All religions are compatible, and it is important for people to maintain their own traditions and way of life. My life task, bringing divisions through peace, as an AVP at least, as a Quaker, as a member of MSD International. I hope to establish bridges and eliminate borders. In order to do so, I must experience other cultures, religions, peoples, races, and civilizations, and find and absorb their core values. I will be important to lead my life in the manner of those who always seek truth with an open mind. Religion is not complete. It continues to change, flow and grow. Diligence is leading with this process. God is unfinished and growing. My lecture. Let us go into the cycle.